We can't ignore this. WA Premier Mark McGowan, who turned his state into some sort of a hermit kingdom within a hermit kingdom during COVID, made a shock announcement yesterday to step down saying, "I'm tired, I'm extremely tired." Now, Sophie, I know you're the media writer for The Australian, so let's have a look at some of the media coverage. The WA media were typically glowing. Here is The West Australian with a look back on Mark McGowan's incredible life. Oh, I mean, did he write that? Did his media team write that? And Nine were just as cringeworthy. Listen to this.
Mark McGowan was our COVID premier, navigating 3 years of chaos and confusion, earning the nickname State Daddy, his lasting legacy, a tough border policy that put WA on the global map.
Oh, dear me. And that report went for about 7 minutes. It didn't get much better. So the adulation he's had in the WA, the support from the media has been quite profound. But this was a shock to many, this decision.
It was a shock that, because he is at the top of his game. Love him or loathe him, he is popular.
Oh, yes.
Liberals have two seats in Western Australia.
Thoroughly hopeless.
They are thoroughly hopeless. But two seats, I mean, really? They could use a mini minor and fit in their party in the one vehicle. But some of this media reporting looks really to me like propaganda, Rita. I mean, are they doing like send-offs? Like, this is like, you know, a farewell tribute to such a wonderful leader. I find it really quite bizarre.
It is bizarre. And it's someone who now is opened the show talking about the harms of lockdown and all the psychological, all the social, all the economic impacts, you would think now there would be some scrutiny of the decision-making. But no, even now it's just, oh, he's saved us. He's our daddy. Give me a break.